Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding political vacuum in the Bihar written by Yogendra Yadav. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very important for political science optional students. Now this editorial is written by a cephalologist, that is Yogendra Yadav. Now as a cephalologist, what he does is he looks into the election results on the basis of the electorate chemistry that is existing in India. Now Yogendra Yadav, he also prognoses about how the future election results would be unwinding and unfolding on the basis of the caste equation, class equation and the prospects of governance. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the political vacuum that is existing in India. This editorial is about how there is a lack of singular force to challenge the brigade of Bharatiya Janata Party. This editorial is also about how the incompatible forces have come together to put forward, to put against a challenge to the Bharatiya Janata Party. This editorial is also about how this kind of amalgamation of the disparate and incompatible forces is not a good omen for a country like India, in which we stand for certain virtues like secularism and liberty and profoundness and diversity. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to look into the strengthening of the BJP party. The BJP as a force, it has strengthened from the days of independence. Earlier it was not called as Bharatiya Janata Party, it was just called as Jansang, Bharatiya Jansang. Now from the days of Bharatiya Jansang, it has evolved to a political party on the agenda which is incompatible with the spirit and the conscience of the Indian constitution. The conscience exhibits, the constitution tells and gives us the idea of a diversified and secular India. But on the other hand, Bharatiya Janata Party, it promotes the idea of majoritarianism, it promotes the idea of less secular a country, it promotes the idea of saffronization, it promotes the idea of Hindi, Hindu and Hindutva. Now in the Bihar election, what we have seen is the incompatible amalgamation. What we have seen is the congruency of the incongruent forces. The incongruent forces like Janata Dal party. Now JDU party, it was a kind of a party which had strengthened itself, which had based itself on the total agenda of providing good governance to the people. On the other hand, we have RJD, the party of Lalu Prasad Yadav, that has a kind of a image, that has a kind of incredibility of providing less good a governance to the people. So it was a kind of mix of one providing good governance and on the other hand, the other one providing less good governance. So it was a kind of a forced compatibility that was brought into being to challenge the brigade of Bharatiya Janata Party. And the third coalition partner that was existing was Congress. Congress has always tried to project itself as a party that has always tried to uphold the value system of the constitution of India. Now this editorial is also about a kind of a negative feeling, a kind of a sorry state of affairs of how India cannot come out with some other political force other than Bharatiya Janata Party and Congress. This editorial is also about how the third front politics has not been able to strengthen and cement itself. But of late, in this current scenario, when the BJP has tried to project itself as the sole player at the national level, there are chances that the India might be seeing a rejuvenation, a strengthening, a cementation of the third front. And the third front, at the phase, in the beginning, it might look like that the forces are disparate, that the forces are different, that they are incompatible, that they are incongruent. But in the days ahead, what we will be witnessing, that these disparate, incompatible forces might glue with each other very well on the basis of core agenda. Now, at the phase, it might seem that the three disparate forces had come together to challenge the brigade of BJP on the basis of lack of agenda. But there was not a lack of agenda, there was not a lack of substance. These three political parties, they have amalgamated, coalesced with each other in order to challenge the saffronization, in order to challenge the pseudo-secularism that was being persuaded by BJP. So it was not about governance, it was not about development. But the coalition that is existing, it had existed to challenge what was being offered by Bharatiya Janata Party. So it would also be wrong to say that there is a complete political vacuum. Political vacuum exists only when you are not having a kind of a counter to your opponent. But when you are having a kind of a counter to your opponent, there is a kind of non-existence of political vacuum. Yes, the amalgamation, the coalition, the new coalition lacks in big substance. They lack in a kind of inertia which can hold them for long. So there is a need in India to come out, to rejuvenate with a new idea which could stand against Bharatiya Janata Party. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to view the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our website eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And please do participate in answer writing program that we have started on brainiki.com. And do install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.